Well, my takeaways were very simple, that there was no clear winner last night in the sense that no one stood out greatly last night. I think Elizabeth Warren and Pete Buttigieg did very well, but they didn't break away from the pack last night. When you have 10 people, it's very hard to really get your opinions out there. Mr. Yang didn't get to speak to after 30 minutes into the debate. So it's really hard to really get a lot of press time and really expound upon your positions in a debate when you have 10 people running. I think in the next debate right now, there's only six who have qualified. That number could go up to maybe eight or nine, but it's going to be a few less than we have right now. So you're going to have a little more chance to talk. But again, when you have this many people in a debate, it's very difficult to get your position out. I think what's happening, the candidates right now are getting overshadowed by the impeachment. I mean, for example, yesterday you had like 10 hours of time of impeachment hearings. How many people went from that to watch the debate later on in the evening? So I think that's hurt the debates in the sense where people are probably less watching it because of all the other impeachment information. The press is also focusing on the impeachment. So the candidates cannot get as much press as they want. Keep in mind, however, the candidates right now are not so much concerned about national press. They're concerned about press in Iowa, New Hampshire, Nevada, South Carolina. Those are the first four early states. If they don't do well in those states, their campaign's not going to go national and keep on moving. So they have to focus on those states right now. And they're spending a lot of money in those states on advertising. So they keep getting their message out, but the general public is focusing on two things right now in those states, the impeachment and the primary. I think people are now sort of expecting Joe Biden to have a few blunders in every debate. The problem he's had five debates. He has not stood out in any one of those debates. He's held his own in a couple of them, but he keeps having these little blunders that sort of push him backwards. I thought early in the debate, Joe Biden was talking about how he's electable, how he's the person down the middle, and that the voters would vote for him over Donald Trump. And I think that was a good case to make to the voters in the country. But then he goes and has his little stumbles, and that takes off that message, and people talk about the stumbles instead.